Now let's talk about former Notre Dame right tackle, guard center prospect, Robert Hainsey. I'm going to give you my take on Robert Hainsey. You tell me what you think about it, or you can just dive into it. Either one, I'll leave it up to you. I will not be shocked if Robert Hainsey starts more games in the NFL than anyone else that we're talking about in this draft, because I think when you talk about everything that an offensive line coach wants outside of measurables, Robert Hainsey has. Two-time captain at Notre Dame, was the only captain at IMG Academy his senior year. Incredibly experienced, absolutely going to come with the Harry Hiestand stamp of approval in a lot of different ways. Consistency, and I think the biggest thing is he is in an era when you're dressing sometimes 7-8 offensive linemen in a game. Having a guy that can play four different, I think the only position he can't play at least in a game where you need to plug him in is probably left tackle. And even there, I think if you had to put him in an emergency situation, he could get you out of a game. But I think he's a guy that could start at all three interior positions and could play right tackle in a pinch if you needed to in the right system. Obviously lacks the length. His measurables were almost identical to Zach Martin's, which is why he's projected as an inside guy. But I think he is one of the most underrated players, and I think he's the epitome of steadiness. He's not flashy. He doesn't have – Liam Meichenberg will have some dominant blocks. Robert Hainsey does not. I think he's an incredibly steady player, and some NFL team is going to say, we got to have that guy, and he's going to surprise people and start for a very long time. That's just my stance on Robert Hainsey, because I've been breaking him down now for 4 years, and I'm just watching him win battle after battle after battle, and just never gets the love and appreciation that I think his level of play at Notre Dame projected. What say you, Ryan?
Well, I think you hit it on the nail on the head, and a great point, Brian, is the fact of everybody wants to talk about, you know, oh, he's the starting left tackle for this amount of years. There are a lot of players that make a long career out of being able to back up multiple positions, that swing player, the swing tackle, the swing interior player. And for me, I agree. I think that Robert Hainsey is going to be able to back up all three interior positions, or start at least at one interior position, then back up the other two, and play some right tackle in a pinch if, you know, chaos ensues.
Mm-hmm.
And if you ask me, who was the biggest winner in Senior Bowl week out of Notre Dame prospects, I would tell you it's Robert Hainsey. I know everybody wants to talk about Dalen Hayes, who had a great week. Everybody wants to talk about Adi Ogundeji, who had some insane measurables.
Mm-hmm.
When you look to ask me who helped themselves the most, because Robert Hainsey went into the game being a four-year player at right tackle. We hadn't seen him inside. And I mean, my immediate response was, after you see the 32-inch arms, was, hey, he's going to be a guard. But the revelation of the week for me was being able to see him snap the football and to win some one-on-ones snapping the football. So now my understanding of Robert Hainsey has changed a little bit. It's a pure projection because we haven't seen him in at center, but I saw him dominating some very good football players on a lot of reps in at center. So now my thought process is Robert Hainsey a starting caliber center? I think that he can be. Why can't he be? He's battle tested. He's consistent. He's a technician. He understands leverage clearly. Why can't he be that guy? And he showed consistent snapping all week, even though it wasn't a thing that he hasn't done in a game up until that mm-hmm. point. So I'm excited about Robert Hainsey, and I think that he is going to carve out a long niche, and I think that he's going to be a day three steal for someone, because at worst, we're talking about a valuable swing player on the next level that's going to back up multiple positions. But for me, is he a starting caliber center? I think he might be, because I think that the smarts, the toughness, the consistency, everything that you highlighted, I think all play really well into playing center. And I think that he could be that communicator on offensive line, because he's just been that guy for Notre Dame. You know, the guy that you're talking about from the leadership quality, the communicator perspective, like, he's just been that beam of consistency for Notre Dame for 4 years. So I'm looking at him and I'm just saying, why can't he be a starting caliber center? I think all the tools are there to work with.
And I think from what I've heard too, talking to different sources, he crushed it at the Senior Bowl from an interview standpoint. But that should shock no one. You're a Notre Dame fan. That should shock no one. I mean, that's just kind of who Robert Hainsey is. But I thought I would say this. Not only did he improve the most, I thought he had the most at stake at the Senior Bowl.
Agreed.
I think because again, he's not an NFL tackle. Like, I don't see anyone saying we're going to start him at right tackle. When I talk about he can play tackle, it's more of a, you're in a game and you're down a couple guys and you need someone to get you out of that game. I think Robert Hainsey could get you out of that game. And that's important. But like you said, that versatility alone would get him drafted. If someone then views him as, to me, the Senior Bowl, and this is my opinion, this isn't talking to any sources, this is strictly my opinion. Knowing NFL teams and coaches the way that I do, there are going to be some O-line coaches that are going to now be having a completely different conversation about Robert Hainsey. To your point, hey, can this guy be a starter? Can this guy be a starting center? You know, when I look at, you know, his size, right, which is the knock on him, his length and his size, is not really an issue at center. Because the thing about center that's different from every other position in the NFL, on the offensive line, center's the one position that you can protect from both sides. And it's harder to do that at guard in the NFL because your tackles have to spend so much time on the edge in protection. Center can always be protected in some way, somehow. We've seen plenty of undersized centers that have been outstanding NFL football players because they're quick off the ball. They play with good leverage. They understand angles and all that kind of stuff. And I think Robert Hainsey has that. I also think his athleticism plays up better at center than it did at tackle. I think that's another big thing. I think he went from being an average right tackle athlete to a good athlete at center. And I think that's another factor in it. So I think that there are going to be some NFL teams that are going to be having completely different conversations about Robert Hainsey as they dive more into the film after they talk to Harry Hiestand, and then obviously after what they saw from him at the Senior Bowl. Because to your point, not only did I think he had the best week, I think he had the most at stake. I think the only other guy that you can maybe argue had more at stake was maybe Ian Book, just because of the position that he plays. And it is after the first batch of first round quarterbacks, there's a big drop off. I could see him with a great week having snuck up a little bit. I don't think that he did, but I just think Robert Hainsey had a lot at stake, and the fact that he stepped into it playing positions. I mean, there were times you saw it, right? He played both guard spots and center, not just in practice, but in the game, and played them all like he'd been doing it for years. Especially, I thought he was really good at guard, which you'd expect a little bit more of an easier transition to guard. But the center piece on day two, when he started playing center, I thought that really just skyrocketed him in my view.
Yeah, and it's another great point, because we're talking about a player that's going to have to do something on the next level that we had never seen him. So obviously everything is at stake for him. Like, you don't have reps of him at guard. You don't have reps of him at center. That's the first time you're going to see it. So if we're projecting him to a different position, I mean, it's not a great comparison, but like Braxton Miller a few years ago, the quarterback from Ohio State, you had barely seen him play wide receiver at Ohio State. Barely. He was a wildcat guy, basically. Mm-hmm. Goes to Senior Bowl, shows some chops as a route runner, shows some dynamic ability, and then he's drafted in the third round. Now, he obviously didn't pan out. Like, I think a Robert Hainsey has a better chance because he's just so darn consistent. But you had never seen those reps, and you would never have had those reps if you didn't have that opportunity, especially in a draft process year where the NFLPA Bowl was fully virtual, the East-West Shrine Game was fully virtual. This opportunity that Robert Hainsey had, not only was it huge for him just in a limited resume-building draft process, but also you made the most of your opportunity. You showed that, hey, I can play these multiple positions. Even though you never saw me there before, I'm competing against some of the best seniors in the country at something that is completely foreign to me and completely new. And I think that he, again, was the biggest winner if you're talking about just from where he started to where he finished. Robert Hainsey had an outstanding week, and the arrow is pointing firmly up for him.